Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to my channel. Today, I wanted to talk about one of my old friends, succulents. That's right, I sound so annoying. So succulents are what started it all for me. I just recently got into, not recently, but like in the last couple years, I got into more leafy houseplants. But succulents have been with me from the jump of my obsession. They are what started it all for me. I live in California, so succulents are just, you know, this is like where it's at for succulents. They can grow outside all year round where I live. So I wanted to honor them. Just give my care tips because I have truly mastered the succulent situation. And I know a lot of houseplant people don't love them or don't get them. They just don't understand them. But I do. And that's why I wanted to tell you what they're feeling and thinking. Okay? So I hope this video helps and let's get to it. So I know a lot of, you know, articles and whatever, they say that succulents can grow indoors and everything, and while yes they can, I really wouldn't keep them inside unless they're getting direct sunlight for at least 4 hours a day. And that means like sun is hitting them, because if you have it like in the room, you know, with bright light, like bright indirect light, no. You're gonna get one leggy, stretched out, like stressed out looking plant. Like it's gonna look like it's begging for death. And you don't want that vibe in your house, right? So only get succulents if you have direct sun to give it. And I know like in California, I can grow them outside all year round, no problem. And I would say like morning sunlight is ideal for them outside. If you have them inside, I would suggest south-facing window, like maximum light. Succulents are not the best indoor plants, and it always confuses me when people are like, yeah, like just like pop one in a pot and like put it on by your TV, and it's like, what? No, it doesn't belong by the TV. It belongs in the window, like right up on its face, right on the window, like that. So that's the light needs. So I think we all know that cactus and succulent mix is ideal for these guys. I've used Espoma and even the Miracle-Grow, and that seems to work really, really well for them. Watering these guys, that's the all-time famous issue. Just wait until the soil is completely dry. Like you put your finger in there and you're like instantly thirsty yourself. You're like, oh my God. That's when you water them. Like I only water these guys when they start to get kind of shriveled looking. Like here, I'll show you. See how it's looking a little shriveled? That's when you know that the plant is really thirsty, and that's when I'm gonna start giving it more water, is when it's starting to shrivel up a little bit. And then when you do water them, drench the hell out of them. Like even if you can soak them in water, just drench them in water. You don't wanna just like a little water. Like you want a lot, like all up in there, you know, when they're bone dry, pretend you're a monsoon ripping through their little pot and you're like, you know, destroying them, but with love and water. Then you just wait for a long time. Sometimes, especially in the winter, you might not have to water them for like a month, you know, like you really just feel the soil. And even if it is dry, but they don't appear thirsty, then just wait. You just have to learn to read them, read the soil and the moisture levels, and one day you will be a master. And look at this guy. So this guy just started having like all these cool colors, and that's what happens. A lot of succulents, when they get like a lot of direct light, they change colors and they just become like a different plant. It's just really cool to watch. So fertilizing succulents is a good thing to do in the summer months when they're really trying to push out new growth, because that's their season, obviously, is when it's really, really hot. That's what they thrive on. They love that heat, that intensity. It's been really hot here in my house lately, so I think they've been blowing up even more because they're just like, yes, like sunlight, you know, like that's what they want. So fertilizer, I've just been giving them fish fertilizer now for the past few rounds. They seem to love that. I forget the brand, but it's like a cactus succulent specific fertilizer that's like bright green, and it looks very chemically, which is why I switched to fish fertilizer. But they also responded well to the cactus and succulent specific fertilizer. So if you have that, totally use that. Like, that's no problemo. They love that. And I noticed a difference in them when I would fertilize them. They just got like juicier looking, like, you know, like thicker, which is great. But so far, I think they love the fish fertilizer as well. But also, like, if you don't want to fertilize them, they're fine. Like, they don't rely on a lot of nutrition because obviously they're used to very dry climates and not the most nutritious soil. So, like, if you aren't about the fertilizing life, then don't enter the life. There were times where I didn't fertilize them at all and they just kept going. Some of them would flower. I mean, it, you know, they're chill. They're chill about it. All right, guys, so I hope this video was helpful a little bit. I know so much more about succulents, but I just wanted to give a quick video and honor them and, you know, kind of teach you a little bit. I can get into more specific succulents if you guys want, but that's just a general overall succulent care video. So hope that was helpful. Please like, subscribe, keep watching, share, whatever. And I will see you in the next one. Bye. I'm gonna shove this in your face and it's blurry so you can't see it.